you've only got 10 seconds according to the clock. Don't worry, that's a transition.
We're awesome.
And can you bring him up a little bit?
My name is William Yancheski. I'm the CEO and Chief Creative Officer of WonderVerse. We aim to revolutionize how major media franchises are created. In a world where disruptive tech is pretty much the norm, our model is to develop and manage across all of these. Our fans, and you'll see that we have a lot of geek fans, are very diverse and have an evolving tech base. What we do is we take our franchise candidates and pass them through pretty intense filters to pick who we're going to work with. And then we build a roadmap, a blueprint, social hooks, all of that in advance so we actually have the wiring laid down ahead of time for where we're going. So as a startup, but a startup with a pretty rich history, we feel that we finally have all of the tech to create rich, deep, global brands and accelerate them into the marketplace, right from the start. So we work with a network franchise model where all of the storylines, all of our play is deeply connected together. It's what we call our theme park model, where everybody is welcome. We do this through a content operations center that we've developed, which allows all of our teams around the world to work very tightly together. And what I'd like to do today is actually launch our first major franchise here at South by Southwest, Kaiju Empire, and our first major Facebook game, Kaiju Land in beta.
Our studio model
the idea to launch across all the platforms at once, or just to have that capability?
I would say to have the capability. I like to think in terms of threes. So if we can get three things out there right off the bat, I think that's pretty strong. You know, for us, we're launching a Facebook game, the first comic. We have a digital comic coming out in a few weeks. We see our social media. Our Facebook page is already over 51,000 likes, and we haven't launched yet. So I see it's all about communication. And for me, that's it's the web 2.0, 3.0. It's all about feedback and keeping it alive.
I don't really get what you can potentially do better than studios in terms of franchise management. I mean, I'm working for Turner and my current network. When we launch a new franchise, we do all these. So just focus on what you do better.
For years, I've worked as a full-service studio. So I've worked with most of the major brands. And each major studio has its own strengths and weaknesses. Usually the weaknesses involve how they communicate internally, how they work with external partners. For us, we're really living the lean startup and trying to build it from the ground up rather than, you know, there's always somebody in the corner who knows how it should be done, but because of entrenched ways of doing it, it's really impossible to graduate that.
But then do you differentiate by your content or by your processes or your approach to franchise management? What I don't really get.
I think it's both. You know, the process for us is important and sort of a culmination of everything we've learned over the years. But for us, for me, as a creative, it's the content and being able to see it realized across the board.
So this is massive undertaking because you're also doing the game development, or the content development, or comic book writing development. So you have to have a massive team all the way around to do all those things. Again, on the other side, you're doing the actual management. So you're getting into, again, like you said, making sure that the legal is talking to you, the rest of the company, the licensing. So you're looking at building and our building just a huge, massive company, and then having all the based in, from the web.
Yeah, I think it's a new age studio. Taking everything from the past and really applying the lean startup model to it, the accelerator model, something we talk about a lot. You know, I try not to use buzzwords, but you know, we're always at these lean startup accelerators. So I think there's a lot to be learned from that.
Well, I like playing big. Playing big. This is everything that's happening right down the valley. It's what I call billionaire's poker. Everybody's playing for the big end. Want to win a billion. That's the bottom line. So if you want to play, you play big. But this is also man. This takes a lot of people. Is what I'm saying. This will take a company that will have to have 1,500, 2,000 people just to really get going from that. I saw recently the most impressive social game that I've seen. Period. I can't name it because they're not launched yet, but it's just magnificent. And we're 300 people working on it for the last 2 years, and about 20 million invested from one investor. So just saying that you're going to do all these things, which obviously you've got experience, it's going to be a massive undertaking. But it's impressive, when you put it together.
Yeah, I'll tell you that. I don't bet in Las Vegas because you don't have enough control over success. But I think we threw all of our chips behind this one.
Sure.
The first franchise that we considered was a direct mobile launch and didn't have sort of the viral nature. This is a very high concept. Our first franchise is a very high concept. Everybody gets what giant monsters destroying cities are. And it allowed us to, again, have that sort of fan base in groundswell before we even launched.
Well, the key will be going from the word franchise to creating a franchise. That's the deal. So conceptually, it's a franchise, because it's franchise. But becoming a franchise in Hollywood means that you've had a box office of 150, 200 million, 250 million, and then you've established a franchise. The idea is to create those franchises. All right, let's get a question out here real quick.
So the purpose of WonderVerse is as a portal is crowdsourcing creative ideas. Is that kind of where that is going to go, that you filter through and decide on how you want to develop?
No. The WonderVerse for us is partially a destination. Our original company name was Kaiju Empire, but we always knew that it was more than that franchise. So we backed Kaiju Empire into WonderVerse, which is the studio. But I think that WonderVerse will eventually have a lot of connections with the audience. One of the things I've always found sort of challenging is huge franchises like, for instance, Star Trek. It's hard to make games about Star Trek as much as I love it, because everybody wants to be one of three or four main characters. Nobody wants to be Red Shirt. So part of crafting a franchise for us is creating something that people can feel that they own. So with Kaizen Land, every month there's a new giant creature release that people can customize, and it's an ongoing serial-based platform as opposed to sort of grinding, raising corn and harvesting it. So yeah.
But the first part of the presentation referred to a filter whereby you could decide if you can own it or develop it. What does that reflect?
That's our own internal process. In order to invest as much money and time into these things, we really make these ideas run the gauntlet before we're okay investing in
it. So how big a team did it take to create just this set of Kaizen Land content?
We've been at this for about 14 months. We started pretty small. I would say at the height, we probably had about 20, 25 people. We're about half that now as we're sort of polishing and wrapping it.
And you raised money?
I invested a lot in Apple stock when I was young.
Self-funded.
All right, we got about 30 seconds. One more question.
How is this a new model for those of us that don't understand the studio model?
Sure. You know, it's the hard thing, I'm trying to make this fast. The hard thing is that a lot of what I'm selling up here is stuff that we've heard over and over from the entertainment business. And I was always it's always Silicon Valley means Hollywood. Well, that never quite worked. We're the baby of that divorce who actually grew up doing all of the types of media, filmmaking, television, game development, and so forth. So for us, it's really about being that group that is native to this.
All right, that's WonderVerse.